For more on the relief efforts, let's bring in Mark Nouveau. He's a former FEMA coordinating officer. Mark, good morning to you. Just tell us a bit about the massive challenge that FEMA has before them, given the devastation there, in particular in Kentucky.
Yeah, good morning, Dave. You heard the governor as well as the emergency management director just talk about, you know, power's out, water, you know, they're delivering water to different areas. They're trying to get generators to nursing home, long-term care facilities. So you can see this is going to be a long, drawn-out effort, but it's a partnership. You also heard the governor talk about how quickly the federal government, in partnership with the state of Kentucky and local officials, are starting to get resources on ground to help people. So that's great news.
How does this compare to some of the devastation you've seen when you were in office, and how do they prioritize?
Yeah, good question. You know, what we're seeing and what we've heard from the governor, and he was quoted as saying this is the deadliest December for tornadoes in Kentucky in history. So the devastation is so large. We're talking about a 200-mile swath. So once that tornado sat down, it took out, you know, 200 miles of buildings and homes, et cetera. Because of the size of that, it makes it difficult to be able to assess. So what they've done, in particular for people and you know, trying to rescue them, is they've brought in three additional urban search and rescue teams to go comb through all that debris, not only to try and recover those who are lost, but hopefully there are some that are buried in that rubble they can still rescue. So they're starting a recovery as well as a rescue operation at the same time. It is going to be challenging because it covers six states and three FEMA regions. Very much a challenge, Dave.
Just looks like an absolute war zone. We just heard from the governor of Kentucky that at least 64 Kentucky residents died. They are working to update all those numbers. When you've got families that have lost literally everything, they have nothing left, how do you begin to help those families? Obviously, first and foremost is finding them a place to stay.
Yeah. So it's kind of a tiered system. What's going to happen in a lot of states, what you can do is if you lose everything, you can use a thumbprint at the Department of Motor Vehicles, go down, explain to them what's happened. You'll probably have to go to an adjacent town that starts the process of getting some important documents, license, et cetera, and that starts the recovery. But right now, we're still early in the point. So what they're going to do, and you heard a little bit about it just a few minutes ago, is they're starting to ship out water, meals, etc., cots, sleeping bags, infant care materials, and they'll put those at points of distribution. In other words, it might be a community center, might be a police station, fire station. So you're getting essential stuff to those folks on the ground. At the same time, you're opening up shelters. Again, that could be schools, community centers, whatever. Red Cross is great at doing this. Some of the non-governmental organizations will be helping so people can get in and out of the cold for a period of time. Also, with the presidential major disaster declaration that took place last night, it's going to open up housing for people so they can register and call. Either you call a FEMA number, you can do it by computer. You can get funds to go to different locations, whether it be apartments or hotels, so you can have temporary housing while you're going through the recovery part.
Yeah, how significant is that disaster declaration? What does it mean for the government's ability to help? And as you mentioned, for the people on the ground.
Yeah, this was a big one because previous it was an emergency declaration, where now this is a major presidential disaster declaration. And what that does is it brings all the resources of the federal government, every federal agency, to come help whatever the governor and local officials request in terms of assistance. Now, that might be funeral assistance, that might be housing assistance. We talked about food and water, debris clearance. We talked a little bit about how many tons and yardage of debris that's going to be needed to clean up. They've got to do that to be able to put up roads so they can restore power and water to some of these areas. So the major declaration is going to help in a multitude of different ways to ease some of the suffering there.
We're not just talking about the typical tornado season in Tornado Alley. We're talking about mid-December in the southeast region. And the current FEMA administrator told CNN yesterday that this is the new norm. Do you agree with that assessment?
Yeah, what Deanne said, certainly in the new norm, not only with tornadoes, but we're seeing that with wildfires in California, hurricanes in different areas. What used to be seasonal, whether a wildfire season or a tornado season, hurricane season, they're going throughout the year now, and they're lasting longer and they're more severe. If that's climate change, whatever, something has changed and it's causing folks to suffer and these events to require much more work, planning, and resources to recover from.
Quickly, Matt, Mark, is there anything people can do out there? A lot of times these disasters bring out the best in the American people. Is there anything you would urge our viewers to do this morning if they want to help?
Yeah, your point's a real good one here, and it can't be understated. These disasters, the federal government, FEMA comes in and helps. You know, you got Kentucky Emergency Management in one case, you got six other states involved, but it's really the non-governmental agencies. It's Red Cross, it's Rubicon, it's neighbor helping neighbor that comes. Those are the things that make a difference. Right now, what they need is probably donations. You saw the website just a few minutes ago that you guys had on air. For those folks affected, right now it's contributions so they can purchase goods and services. Rushing down there is a website for people to volunteer to help at the shelters. Those are probably two of the best things. Contribute, volunteer, but do it through those websites so they can keep it organized.
And that website right now at the bottom of your screen, the governor said zero administrative fees, and that one obviously so helpful. Mark Nouveau, former FEMA coordinating officer, really appreciate your time this morning. Thank you, sir.
You're welcome. Thank you, Dave.